Fine. So when we have mutable and immutable data structure, it was mutable was something where we can actually change the data, and immutable was we are not supposed to change the data. That is the difference between mutable and immutable. Later we started something with respect to the different functions like ID function, we saw type function. Then we got to know how to know the different functions present inside the directory. Then how to know the different functions present inside the inside the dictionary, inside the list. Okay, list is represented by square bracket, dictionary represented by the flower bracket. Then what are different functions, how to use those functions, about the help function. This is what we revised. Later what we did was we started to define our own function, which we call it as custom function, correct?
Yes.
Yes. So what is custom function? Custom function is if we want to define our function however we want, that is called as custom function. So to do create a custom function, we use a keyword called as def, means it's a define. So def followed by the function name, open bracket, close the bracket is to, then we can give the arguments a equal to 1, b equal to 10, like whatever the function you want, you can just create it. That is what we learned in the previous classes. Agree? Okay, good. After that, what we did was we started with the controlling the statement. That is called as control flow of the statement. What is control flow of the statement? Control flow means to say that given a particular data, I want to understand whether the person to vote or whether the person not to vote. Correct, true or false case of scenario. So that is called a function. I mean, that is to the conditional statements. We saw simple conditional statement, which is called as if and else. Simple if and simple else. Agree? Is it audible for everyone? Is there any disturbance?
Yes, yes.
Is it okay?
It's okay, it's okay.
Following. Okay, great. So now whenever we have like conditional statements, we are like if else and a simple if and simple else, correct? For example, I took an example telling it as age equal to 18, then I said like if age is greater than or equal to 18, then I say vote, else I say do not vote. Correct? Yes. Okay. After that, now we see something called as in conditional statements. In conditional statements, actually we have different thing. Okay, conditional statements. Okay, we saw simple if else. We saw simple if and else, correct? We saw simple if else. Okay, now we have something called as if else ladder. Now I want you people to try on your own. I'll just tell what it is. Okay, if else ladder mean to say that I will ask the user, okay, to tell his marks, to tell his grade. If in case, if a student has scored more than 90%, then greater than 90%, then I say something like, okay, it's less than. Okay, greater than 90, then I say you have got A plus grade. Okay, greater than 80, then I say you must get something like A grade. Okay, then greater than 70, then I say you have got B plus grade. Greater than 60, then you got B grade. Less than 60, I say fail. Okay, so I need some programming like this, where you people must ask the student's percentage and you must display their grade. Okay, so this is the use case of, like, this is what we want to define, how to do these things. Here, what I do know is, I have multiple conditions here. I can say something like, if your percentage is greater than or equal to 90, then I say print A plus grade. No, it is not greater than or equal to, then I check L if, we call it as L if your percentage is greater than or equal to 80, then I say B A grade. No, this is also not true. Then I check for one more L if. Okay, it's just nothing like else if. L if your percentage is greater than or equal to 70, then I say B plus grade. No, this is also false. Oh, this is also false. Then I try one more. Else if your percentage is greater than or equal to 60, then B grade. No, this is also false. Then finally, okay, else you have failed. This is what I require. Following it, how to construct a programming for this? Can people try? Everyone?
Yes, Vinay. And I have a question. So in here, can we have after if percentage greater than or equal to 90, can we have inside another if else?
Yeah, that is also like we go next. Actually, we have something called as nested if. Okay, we go to the later As of now, what we are doing is we are just seeing this scenario. As you told, as you asked the question, yes, possible, Girish, this is possible. Okay. If okay. One more if inside it, correct? We'll do that.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Okay, fine. So I want people to try this. Can people try this? So you know how to try this. I first of all define a function, def function, function by name, something like, you know, display. Display. This is a function name. Okay. Now I'll ask the user print, enter your percentage. Enter your percentage. Okay. User enter the percentage. I'll scan it. I'll say percentage is equal to. I want everyone to answer now. How to scan the percentage now? How to scan?
Int of input.
Int of.
Input. Okay, we have got a percentage. Great. Now we need to check for the percentage. I check if percentage is greater than or equal to 90, then what I want to do? I want to say as print. Print what? Print A plus grade. Okay, great. Then no, it is not greater than or equal to 90. Then I say elif. Elif what? Check for the percentage. Elif percentage greater than or equal to 80. Then I say print what? Print.
Agree.
I want to be able to complete this. What next?
Elif percentage greater than or equal to.
Correct. 7. Again, elif percentage is greater than or equal to 70. Yes, I say what? Print?
Print B plus.
Very good. B plus grade. Okay. Okay, this is also not true. He's not good score more than 70 also. Then I say LF. What? Percentage is greater than or equal to 60. If this is the case, then I say print what? B grade. B grade. Okay. No, this is also false. Then what? Else, if not either of the cases, else directly say print fail. Agree? I'll run it. I want to be able to make it fast. If you are writing, you can take it on, or else you can type on your system. Okay, but this is what we are following. This is just like we have something like if, elif, 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 finally else. This is called as else if ladder. What? Else if ladder. As I told you, there are three clauses. There are three different ways of handling the conditional statements. One is simple if else. The second one is else if ladder, what we saw now. The third one is called as nested else if. We try that next. This is else if ladder. Following it. Following you, people.
Yes.
Girish, you follow?
Yes, yes. Yes, yes.
Manoj. Sangavi. Anil.
Yes, I'm following.
Someone is named as Del. I don't know what to tell. Del, you know, Manoj is Del. Who is not named as Del? I don't know. Del is not talking. Okay.
This is Del.
Sorry?
Shreya.
Oh, very good, very good. You are doing very good marketing for Dell. Okay. Okay, great. So now, what do we do next is, we'll just run this. Okay, we'll just run. I'll just run this display. I'll see what happens. Okay, I'll run display. It will ask me for the percentage. Spelling mistake, you must bear with this. Okay, I'll say something like 90.
One minute, Vinay. I have a doubt. If we have in now percentage, if they want to enter in float, so should we give now float of input or
into? Yeah, input? Yeah. You can give. We can typecast here as float. Yeah, yeah, you typecast it as int, right?
Yeah.
Rather than that, you can typecast as float.
Okay. Yeah,
sure. So the input will be taken as float.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. Good question. Okay. Enter percentage. I've entered 90. Okay. It says A plus grade. Correct? Correct? Okay. Now, the opportunity for you people, where you people have to tell what is the other use cases of LC Flatter. Where all you can use this. One example I told you. Next. I want everyone to answer for this question. Yes, individually. Where else can we use this?
Income tax slab.
Fantastic. Okay. Income tax slab. So depending upon their income, we can fix their tax, right?
Correct.
Good. Other examples. I want everyone to answer. Shreya.
Performance of employees, like in companies.
How can you give an example?
Better than incentives.
Incentives. So now how can you take? Give an example.
Like based on performance of employees, like we can like give them their incentives. Like if the performance is like below average, then
good.
Then if it is greater.
Yeah. Nice understanding. Good. Then next, Manoj. Manoj.
Sir.
Your answer. Where can we use this? Yes, sir. Any example from your side?
Awesome.
No. You must try, man. Okay. Anil, any example from your side?
From my side, like if any ages is greater than 60, mm-hmm. it will be the our like aged person. We can mm-hmm. print as aged person. Mm-hmm. If it is less than age 40. 30 plus age, we can say it is as a like maturity person, okay. If like less than 25,
yeah.
30.
Yeah, good. Like, see, what I usually expect is like you people have to think in the real world scenarios. For example, you can give an example telling it as, okay, income with respect to government of Karnataka, when I say the income slab is less than 1 lakh per month, then I can give something like BPL card. If income is more than, you know, like between 2 lakhs to 4 lakhs, then they have something like other card, more than 4 lakhs, some ration card, something like that. So I want people to think where this use cases can be used, where this scenarios can be. Okay. So I want people to think like this, so that I am giving example with a lame example with respect to marks and all those things, but I want you people to think where it can be used in your projects or where it can be used in the real world. Okay. Following.
Good.
Okay. So this is with respect to the simple else if. Now we'll go to the next one, which is called as a nested else if. Nested else if, I'll give an example. Okay, let's take the same voting example there, where I display something like def vote. I'm defining a function called as def vote. And I'll ask the user here as print, enter your gender. Okay, last, enter your gender. Okay, then I'll scan the gender. I use something like gender is equal to, now must I put input or int of input?
Just input.
Fantastic.
Just input.
Yes. Just input. I say input. Okay. Next, I say print, enter your age. Enter your age. Okay. It says, I'll enter the age. I'll say age is equal to int of input. Fantastic. Okay. Then what I do now is, I check for the age. If in case age is greater than or equal to 18, then I let them to come inside the polling booth, inside the election booth. Then I'll ask their gender. I see the ration card, voter card, and I say, oh, if gender equal to male, then I say you can vote, go to male line. Print, you can vote. You can vote and go to male line. Oh, this is what I can give an example. Very good example. Then I say no, else what? Okay, else I say print, go to female line. I can handle like for transgender also if you need. Okay, then you can vote, go to female line. Female line, good. Now the age is only not greater than or equal to 18. Then I say directly do one thing else better, print, don't vote, go home. Okay. Do not vote. Yes. So this is an example. So there is one if. Inside one if, we have one more if else. Followed? Can you observe here? I am checking for the age. If his age is greater than or equal to 18, only then I am bothered about their gender. If age is only not up to the mark, then I say directly without checking their ID cards, I say directly, boss, you go, better go home because you can't vote. If in case age is greater than or equal to 18, I see the ration card and say, okay, you go to male line or you go to female line. Following it. So, one if, inside that we have one more if else. This is called as nested if else. This is called as nested if else. I'll check for the scenario. Okay, I'll just say here and I'll call the OAT function. Now the function has been defined. Function has been defined. I'll call it. This is called as calling function. I say OAT. I'll call OAT. When I call this OAT, it will ask for the gender. I say like male. It will ask for age. I'll say 54. It says you can vote and go to male line. Fantastic, right? Yes, now what I'll do is, I'll enter something like, enter gender, I'll say male, and I'll ask for enter your age, I'll say something like 17, do not vote. But you can see the problem here. The problem here is, irrespective of the age, I'm asking the gender, agree? Irrespective of the age, I'm asking the gender. Enter your gender male. First of all, if your age is greater than or equal to 18, only then I must ask your gender, right? So what you can do is, take this print, enter your gender, okay, control X, then I'll check for the age first. If age is up to the mark, only then I'll ask for the gender. Will this make sense?
Yes.
Correct. So this makes sense. So here I'll check for the age. If age is greater than or equal to, only then I'll ask for the gender. If in case, if age is only not greater than or equal to 18, boss, I don't ask your gender, better go home. This is what I say. Okay. So if inside that if else. So the other question, I mean, Girish, hope you got your answer, what you asked for previously.
Yes, Vinay. The only thing is, I had tried the similar thing with the assignment, but if gender is equal to male, is what I was trying to do. It was giving me an error saying it varies in text.
Good observation. See here, actually, he was trying to do gender equal to male. I want people to understand here, we are doing comparison. We are doing comparison. So we put it as double equal to. Okay, put as double equal to. When I'm comparing something, it has to be double equal to. When I'm assigning something, it has to be single equal to. I'm assigning the input to age, so I'm using single equals to here. I'm comparing something here, so I'll use double equals to. Okay, so double equal to is comparison and single equals to is assignment. That is very important. This is where you are going wrong. Okay, I want you to get it. Okay.
Vinay, one more question. If it is numbers, like if it is age equals to 18, then it requires double equals?
Yes, of course. Whenever you have comparison, it has to be double equal. It might be a string comparison or it might be a number comparison. In the previous case, when I was checking for the percentage, I used greater than or equal to. If you can see here. Okay. If I give equal to, then again it becomes wrong. It has to be greater than or equal to or double equal to. Following it?
Got it.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Great. So this is one if, one more, I mean, very good observation here. What we have to do is double equal to is comparison, single equal to is assignment. Okay, I'm doing double equal to, we need to say I'm comparing the gender. If the gender is equal to male, I can say print, you can go vote and go to male line. Else, you can say print, go to female line. Following this, everyone got it? Any doubts for this? Any doubt for anyone? Shall we go next?
Vinay, can you explain that age equal to int input is there, right?
Yeah.
Why it is converted again to integers?
See, as I told you, I'm taking the age. Age is a number here. Age is not a string. I told you string. Okay. String means to say group of characters, something like apple, mango, sapota, banana, Ramesh, Ravi, Raju. This kind of letter, this kind of data is a string. If you are catching those data, then it has to be with a directly input. But if I'm catching the number, if you're catching the number, then it has, the string has to be converted to integer. Okay, that's what actually we discussed in the previous class. I told you, whenever you are converting the string, when I directly give input, it would be taken as string. It would be taken as a word. So even though you enter 18, 18, it is not considering 18 as a number. It is considering 18 as a string. But what do you want? You want 18 as a number, right?
Yes.
So you have to explicitly say, I need that number. So I say int of input, whatever you're taking as input, no, convert that to integer so that I'll be getting a number. That's what I need to say here. Okay. But in case of gender, what happens is gender is of course a string. I need it as a string. So I don't need to convert it to integer because it is a string anyway. So I needed a string, does not a matter. So let it be like in string only. Okay, this with respect to gender. But with respect to age, no, I need it as a number. So I'm typecasting it to integer. Got it?
Yeah.
Great. Okay. Now what I do is, this with respect to if else, nested if else and else if ladder. Are the things clear with respect to conditional statements for everyone?
Yes.
Good. Okay, now what I do is, I have something like, I give an assignment for you people telling it as, okay, I need numbers from 1 to 100, just print it onto the screen. What will you do? I say print the numbers from 1 to 100 on the screen. What will you do? Print 1, print 2, print 3, print 4, print 5, correct, right? You'll be doing print 1, print 2, print 3, print 4, print 5, print 6, print 7, till print 100, you keep on typing 100 print lines, correct?
Yes.
Yes. So there is not a case, because we are a programmer, we need to understand there must be the logic behind it to handle these kind of situations. Yes, this is possible. How? This is called as loops. We have a concept called as loops. What this loops will do? What this loops will do is, I'll do one thing, like I'll say for I in range of 1, 101, 1 is to, then I say print I. I'll see what will be the output. Oh wow, we are getting number from 1 to 100. Always is so, I tell you now. There is something called as for loop. What this for loop will do is, see, actually it is very abstract. It is very abstract. It is very hidden with respect to Python. But when you go to other programming languages, usually when you go to Java, the things are very clear, where I say something like, for loop has three parameters, which is called initialization. Then I say something called comparison. Then I have something like increment or decrement. We have three parameters. Something like initialization, then we have comparison, then we have increment or decrement. These are the three parameters present inside the for loop. It is not only inside the for loop, in any loop. What is loop? When I say loop, what flashes your mind? When I say loop, what it means?
Repeated activities.
Exactly. When I say loop, it means it is a repeated activity. So when I say something has to be repeatedly done, then we use something called as loop. Great. Okay. So now I need to do something again and again and again and again until my my task is completed. If that is the case, then you have to use something called as loop. If so, how to do that? We have two kind of loops. One is called as for loop. Other one is called as while loop. These are the two important loops present in any programming languages. We have something like for loop and while loop. Okay. Now I'll ask you a question. What is this for loop and what is the while loop? Okay. See, both does the same thing. Okay. Both the for loop and the while loop does the same thing, but how we do is different. Okay. First of all, loop mean to say repeated activity. Whenever you want to do some actions again and again and again, we will be using something called as loops here. Okay. Now what I do is, I'll go to the loop. How exactly loop will happen? I told you there are three parameters. Can you please repeat it? What are the three parameters present inside the loop?
Initialization, then
good.
Comparison,
good.
And increment or decrement.
Fantastic. We have three parameters. Initialization, comparison, increment or decrement. Okay. Now I say I need to initialize something. How to initialize? I say something like I want to start from 1. I start from 1, okay? Then I have to print till 100, and every time I want to increment by 1. What it means? Means to say that print 1, print and increment by 1 time. So 1 will become 2, print 2, increment by 1 more time, print 3, increment 1 more time, it will become 4, 1 more time, 5, 1 more time, 6. Till how many times? Till the number is 100. So I'm initializing I is equal to 1, mean to say initialize I is equal to 1. Go on repeating this unless and until the value of I is less than or equal to 100. Then every time what you do is, the value of I what I have, do as I is equal to I plus 1. See, I am making I value as 1. I keep on repeating this until the value of I is less than or equal to 100. Good. then I am doing I is equal to I plus 1. Followed this. So I have three parameters: initialization, comparison, then increment. This is what actually happens in other programming languages with respect to the for loop. Okay, with respect to the loop for that matter. Let us not be with respect to for or while. I say in loops we have three parameters: initialization, increment or decrement, then comparison. Initialization, comparison, increment or decrement. I'm incrementing it here. Okay, so this is what if I know how this happens with respect to Python programming. Very simple. What I do know is I say something like for I, okay, I in range. Range is a function which accepts three parameters. Range is a function which accepts three parameters: initialization, start from 1, go till 100. I want to print 100 also. So I say 101, then I say 1. Mean to say start at 1. This is stop at 101. This is step by one time always. Start, stop, step are the three different parameters present for range. Okay, now I say start at 1, end at 101, and go by 1. Okay, I'll do this. What you want me to do is I want you to print this always. What you want to print? I want to print this I. Okay, I say print I. Very good. When I print this I, then I'll be getting an output like 1, 101. Okay, I'll say I need some 1, 10, 1. So what will be the output? The output will be something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Why didn't I get 10?
Because in the range it will go from 1 to 10 minus 1.
Exactly. I say that start from 1, go till 10, don't take 10. So whatever the activity happening in this range, it will be assigned inside the variable called as I. I am printing that I. Okay, whatever is happening here, I am putting that to I and I am printing that I. This is what is happening. Okay, now if I ask you, okay, do one thing, just print odd numbers from 1 to 10. Oh, you need only odd numbers. Then I need 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Correct. How would you do that? Okay, start from 1, end at 10. That is fine. Rather than incrementing by 1, increment by 2. Know what happens? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. This is all happening with respect to loop. Are you following this? This is one use case, how to use the loops. Okay, how to use the loops. Now I'll give one more example for you. I say something like list. I have a list L1. Okay, L1 is having something like apple. Then I have something like mango. Then I have something like pineapple. Okay. Now I want to print apple, mango, and pineapple. How can we print? Very simple. No, just do L1. I understand. Just doing L1, it comes something like this. I don't want something like that. I want something like every line I have apple, then I need mango, then I need pineapple, then I want to know something else. How to do that? Use your for loop. That is, every time you want to display fruits, right? Use a for loop. How to use it? I say something like for. Okay, for I in range.
Range of L1.
Okay, range of L1 will give me L1. L1 is accepting the number. Range is accepting the number. I'll repeat. Range is accepting the number here. So when I give L1, you are giving a list. Will that accept?
It is the number.
Yeah, because range is accepting the number. You can see range is accepting the numbers. When I pass L1 here, you are passing the list. Boss, I am expecting a number. You are passing me the list. I can't do anything, it will say. So now what I can do is, I can do something like length of L1. What is length of L1?
3.
Length of L1 is 3. Now I'll just print L1 of I. And try to run this. See, I got apple, mango, pineapple. Okay, now the question comes, Vinay, here in the range actually you pass three parameters, but you are passing only one parameter. Yes, it is not a rule that you have to pass three parameters. Okay, in the range what I do is, I'll just do range of 5. That's it. What do you got? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Range always expects the initialization parameter. Okay, it will say where to start. I mean, when I say 5, it says, okay, I must stop at 5, right? I'm done. I start from 0, I'll go till 5 and I'll stop. Following this. Okay, so it will say, yes, you're passing only one parameter. Mean to say I have to go till that. Okay. If you pass two parameters, the first parameter will be initialization and the second parameter would be comparison. I say 5 comma 10. Now what will be the output? What is the output now? Guess.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
I'll pass three parameters. Then it will take initialization, comparison, then increment. I'll make 2. 5, 7, 8. Oh, in this case, what is happening? In this case, what is happening is, I'll say len of L1. I'll just do len of L1. What is len of L1? Len of L1 is 3. So what it is taking? For I in range of 3. Range of 3. What will be the output? 0 to 3. So it will be 0, 1, 2. So when I say L1 of 0, apple will be printed. L1 of 1, mango will be printed. L1 of 2, what will be printed? Pineapple will be printed. Correct? Agree? Are you following? Is it confusing?
No, it's clear.
Clear? Okay. So I want people to understand this properly, because this is what you actually do in programming. I'll tell the use case, what it will be done. For example, I have something like, you know, I have Sachin Tendulkar, Dravid, Sehwag and Ganguly. I say that I need only Sachin Tendulkar. Then I will check the Sachin Tendulkar positions. I will use if condition inside the for loop. This would be the next part of assignment. Once you send this assignment, I'll be sending the next part of assignment where you people understand how to use that. Okay. But this is important. You must understand how to use the for loop and how to use the conditional statements very properly. I'm taking with a very basic examples, but this examples will actually help you to understand in detail. Are you following this? With respect to for loop. So for loop has how many parameters?
For loop has 3 parameters.
3 parameters. What are those?
Initialization, then the comparison, and then the step.
Increment or decrement. Correct. Step, increment or decrement. So I say for loop, then I'm giving some name to it. Here also I'm having the for loop. I'm giving some name I. I'm doing L1 of I. L1 of I is actually giving the position. L1 of I will be giving the L1 of 0, L1 of 1, L1 of 2. L1 of 0 is apple, L1 of 1 is mango, L1 of 2 is pineapple. This is what actually we are getting. Agree? Correct?
Yes.
Great. Okay. So, I mean, let's not go in hurry actually. Anyways, I have while loop to be completed. Okay, while loop, actually we can take it tomorrow. What I want to people to take this assignment very seriously, and I want people to try that assignment. I try in terms of it has to be done. Okay, it's not so difficult, and I want people to post the assignments to the group through the Word file. Okay, copy your code and paste it in the Word file. I'll let you know whether you've done it properly or not. Only then you learn. And I want people to revise with respect to else if ladder, simple if else, then the for loop in Python. Yeah, I mean, anyways, the video is being recorded. I think someone can share, like, who is recording it actually? Who is recording?
Mono. I am recording.
Fine. Anil is recording. Okay, Anil can just share you. Can share you through WhatsApp group. Okay, so that you can just see the video and try to understand it once again. Okay, any doubts, let me know through the group. Is that okay? Fine. Girish, are you fine?
Yes, yes.
Good. Okay. Shreya?
Yeah, fine.
Sangavi?
Yeah, fine.
Okay. Manoj?
Oh, yes, yes.
Anil?
Yeah, just scroll up for cursor. I want to see one this initialization starting. Yeah, down.
Follow this.
Next one, tough one.
Here?
Yeah, here. Okay, fine. I got it.
Got it? Great. Okay, yeah. Fine then. I want people to practice it. Revisit the video once again. Anyways, we are recording it. That is what we actually have an advantage of seeing the video once again. See the video once again and let me know for any doubts and queries. Okay? Fine then. Okay, tomorrow we'll be meeting once again. Okay. Fine then.
Yeah, yesterday last class record is there for Rohit Gugum.
Someone has recorded it. I don't know. Like, who's recorded in the last class video? I think last class we didn't record anything because I've already sent the video for you, right?
Okay.
I already sent the video. You can just revisit the video so that it would be clear to understand better. Not a problem. From now on, we'll record it. Not a problem. Okay.
Okay.
I sent the video, right? You can revisit the video. You can understand that clearly.
Yeah, I got it.
Great. Okay, then. Bye. Have a nice day.
Bye.
Thank you.
Vinay, Girish here.
Girish, can you just ping me through WhatsApp? I think we are up with the time in Zoom meeting.
Okay, fine.
Okay.